Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. This is episode number one of the Blackburn Rovers career mode. Today we'll be playing two games, one in the Carabao Cup, one in the league. The first game in the league is against Swansea, just in a press conference now. I haven't decided to buy anyone yet. That is just because I feel like we've got a good enough squad. With these two games, hopefully it tells us where we need to improve in terms of the squad depth and all that. But I think the midfield is probably the strongest part. The attack's all right. The defence, it's got depth, but not quality. First game of the season is against Swansea. West Brom have already won the game. I'm not that surprised. One of the best teams in the league. Setting up, here's the team. It's probably the strongest team I possibly could have put out. Playing at Ewood Park to try and get some. We'll try and start off with a win, shall we say. So here we are at Ewood Park. Well, Ivory Lane, tried to customize it a little bit, but here we are, first game of the season against Swansea City. This happened in real life, obviously. I'm pretty sure Rovers won it. But yeah, confident going into this game, but going in the game with an open mind in certain ways, in terms of the team itself. But fingers crossed, we can start with a win. Sense of optimism amongst the fans about the new season and what it might bring. It's been a long wait, but hopefully we get a great game to kick their campaigns off. I'm going to be fully honest, this first half was incredibly dry. Both sides just not really creating that many chances. So at half time, it was 0-0. So we had Travis here and Diaz with a good shot off, but it was a good save. Comfortable. That was our first proper chance of this game. We didn't really have it that many in the first half. Now this was our best chance of the entire game. We have Pervada here, just plays a lovely free ball to Diaz. How straight at the keeper, honestly. Diaz, man, come on. Honestly, that was the hands down our best chance of the game. And here, it was just a perfect ball through. Swansea, oh my days, it hits the bar, honestly. My heart was in my mouth as that happened, because we were in absolutely no man's land. And here we had Swansea in again. Kaminsky, this is probably one of the best saves ever. It's a double save, isn't it? Fantastic. If it wasn't for him, we would have been 3-4-0 down. But he's proper hit the ground running, as they're saying. But yeah, proper good from the keeper. Here from the corner, Lenihan gets it cleared. Then Buttersworth. This guy is extremely fast in game as well to play with. I don't know his exact stats, but he's pretty quick. He gets a nice ball out to Ryan Nyambe. He just trying to find a good cross in. Spots Travis near the edge of the area. Buttersworth can't really get a shot off. Travis passes it to Leighton Clarkson. Leighton Clarkson has a crack. It's a good save by the keeper. But we just couldn't really break them down. Swansea, it was a tough match for our midfield, but that is all she wrote. 0-0 final score. We could have lost that game, and we could have won it at the same time. So it's mixed feelings. I think the best thing we could have come out with was that draw. Obviously, goalless. I'm not happy with the midfield in that coming out of that game, because the midfield just failed to create those chances. Like, they only created one or two out of the entire game. Swansea's midfield were working a lot harder than us. But, yeah. Full time, 0-0. On to the next game. The next game was against Derby County in the Carabao Cup round one. I think we could have had harder draws in the Carabao Cup, because I know there's a few all the Premier League teams we can be drawn against. But I think with Derby, we got a, I don't want to say easy draw, because they are in our league, but compared to what we could have got, pretty decent. Lineup, I fully rotated the team here. I put Piers in net, swapping for Kaminski, because I wanted to give him a little bit of a rest, because Kaminski had an absolute belting game. I think the only player that's played both of these games is Ryan Iambi, actually. But onto the match. Anyway, our first chance in this game was a counter-attack. Pereira plays a good ball to Kadra, and it's a really good finish. Composed, and that is the first goal of this career mode. Kadra, I mean, he kept up. He could have cracked under pressure, but he didn't. Goalkeeper, he'll question his moves, but it's a really good finish. Now, Derby found themselves on the attacking phase. Just misjudged that interception there. And now we had Knight running in at us, trying to find a ball into the box, trying to cover all positions. He does get that ball in. And Derby do get an equaliser. Sibley, not very happy about it, to be honest. It was a bit of a sloppy defending, as they do get another chance. But that's a really good block by Wharton there. And Buttersworth with another great pass. And now it's Kadra on for the second time. Gets a shot off. That is a fingertip save. Fantastic save from the Derby keeper. But yeah, it remains 1-1 at half time. It was, I'd like to say we deserve to be 2-1 up. But it was a really even first half, I would say. Going on to the second half, Derby having a really early chance, and it was a really good chance as well. As what a save from Piers that is. It's fingertip like the other end of a pitch a few hours earlier. But then we decided to make a substitution, get Clarkson off for Bradley Dack, making his first appearance. I know he's out on injury right now, that's why I didn't play him in the very first game, but in terms of depth, we kind of need to put him on to not tire out the other players. And here, Ryan Iambe passes it to Bradley Dack. Bradley Dack gets a through ball to Conor McBride to seal the game. And it's a good save by Derby's keeper. But that was all she wrote in the game, which means this game would go to a penalty shootout. And we really should have buried our chances. But we've still got a chance to win this game and get through to the next round. It's Bradley Dack to step up for the first penalty. Bottom left, green timed, perfect penalty. Next up, the Derby County CDM and the Piers come into safety with a good save. Conor McBride to redeem himself for that last chance, and he does. Close one. And the two out of two, Derby haven't scored one, but that was my bad. Me thinking I could trick the goalkeeper. Now we had Jalfwick, buries it, does what I couldn't do. Joe Rothero now. And suddenly we found ourselves in a very bad place. We bottled a 2-0 lead in the penalty shootout. And Paisley gets sent the wrong way. It's Edun here. Signed this season from Lincoln City. A bit worried about this one, but green time, really good pen. Piers, if he saved this, we would go through to the next round. A lot of pressure. And I wouldn't say it's a good save, but he did it. He did it. Pushes us through to the very next round. And that's all we had time for. Only played two games. I feel like I'm going to play a few off camera, show the highlights, and I'm going to play 2 games an episode until we reach the Premier League. Then I'll play every game and I'll show you it all. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Appreciate the support. And Happy New Year, because I'm recording this on New Year's Eve. Well, a few hours away from New Year's Day. But thanks a lot for watching again. Next episode might be out Saturday, Sunday, around there. But yeah, again, thanks a lot for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.